Hello YouTube world, it's Hey Keisha, and I'm here today to give you a dream that I had. I believe it was last week that I had this dream, but this dream came to me twice within the week, so I'm sure this is a prophetic word that I have for you guys. Stay tuned. So guys, I dreamt that I was coming from a service with my mother. My sister was there also, and my aunt was there, and some other church members that I know was there. And after the service finished, I invited a friend and her daughter, and one of my youngest daughter was there with me. And after service was finished, we were all walking home for some reason, I don't know. We were all walking home, and going home, I saw this lady, an African lady, dressed in an African attire, like with their arms up, and they were floating in the sky, floating off the ground. And I didn't know what this is. I don't know what it is. And someone is like, someone told us that we have to bow down to this person. And if we bow down to this person, then nothing will happen. But if we don't, if we resist the bow down, then we will be destroyed. And I don't know. I don't remember the first dream to that, because I wasn't taking it serious. I just thought that I ate late that night and went to bed. So I didn't really take it into consideration. So I quite don't remember exactly how the first dream went. And 2 days later, again, I have the same exact dream. But this time I remember what it was. And it happens that same thing again. I went to a service, like a convention, something that was going on. Convention, I don't know, something was going on. And as we were walking home again with my mom, we were walking into a group going home, heading home. And now as we were walking, my sister was walking behind me with someone that she knew, I guess someone that she met. And we had an eye contact where she asked me to stop, because she wanted to introduce this girl or this person that she knows to me. She wanted to like introduce her, to let the person know that I was her sister. So I stopped. My friend was with me, so my friend stopped at the same time. My mom continued walking because she didn't notice that we stopped. And then while I was standing there waiting for my sister to come, I realized that the group that we were walking with was way ahead of us. So I'm like, oh my gosh, my mom doesn't have the key. Let me run and stop her and get her back to come and wait until my sister introduced us to this friend. So as I was going to go stop my mom from continuing with the group so that I can go home with her, as I was heading down, I saw this African lady again in an African attire with her arms out, and her legs were, she was floating off the ground. I was like, oh my gosh, I remember my dream. So I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm not bowing down to her. So I am not going any further. And when I looked down the road, everyone that was in the group was bowing down, their head sunk into the ground with their arms down, because they cannot look at this person, and you know, with their bum in the air and their arms down, and everyone was bowed down, and this person was floating. And then I heard someone said, Milwaukee coming, Milwaukee coming, and everyone started to run. Now this dream doesn't seem as if it was, it looks like it's, to me, this is an angel, but not in white and not with wings. This person was floating off the ground. It didn't look, the feeling of this that I was getting, it wasn't a good feeling. It was more like an evil thing. And I didn't want it to bow down to it, so I ran back. And then as I was running back with this person that was yelling out, Milwaukee's coming, not sure what this Milwaukee is. And as I was running back, this lady was running behind me, but I knew now exactly what this thing is, because I had this dream. So I had this dream before, so I knew exactly what this, that this lady's will is going to destroy me if I do not honor her by bowing down. And I ran, and as I call my friend and tell her that Milwaukee is coming, it's gonna destroy us, you need to run. And then as we were running, everyone that comes together to this convention started to separate. No one knows where their friends, their family is. Everyone just has been separated. I realized that my mom bowed out to this thing that was coming, and I was like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And I started in like, oh my gosh, my mom is gonna go to hell now. She's worshiping this thing, she's bowing down, and I'm like praying, God, could you please forgive her? She doesn't know any better. And I run into this building because I was looking for shelter. So I was running. As I went into the building, I remember that my first dream, that when I got into that building got destroyed. I didn't get hurt, but I know that I remember there's a lot of people that got hurt, that got killed. And I remember I walked out of it, but I was hurt, but not, I wasn't dead or anything, but I had a lot of debris and everything on me, and it was hurtful. And as I run into this building, I remember what happened in my first dream. So I'm like, no, this building is gonna get destroyed. So I held my daughter's hand, and I started running. Everyone is running for their life. The lady that was running behind me, she kept going. She didn't stop at this building. I don't know why, probably she knew what was gonna happen, but we just kept running, like looking for shelter, looking for somewhere where this person is not gonna find us so that we don't have to worship her, and so that we are in good accordance with God. And I end up getting up out of my sleep there. And I was like so frantic, because I was like, what kind of dream is this? God, reveal what it is to me. I don't know what kind of dream is this. This isn't a good dream. And what I get from it, honestly, dreaming about, whenever you dream and see a African-American woman in your dream, it's a warning. It means that there is a warning. You are getting a warning, like an African-American or an African, a black lady or whatever. Angel, whenever you see a black angel, it means that angel comes to warn you. And this warning is that we need to seek refuge. We need to seek refuge from God. We need his shelter in the time of trouble, and we need to start preparing ourselves right now, because we don't know when anything is going to happen. Because we were like fine, we had a good service and we were going home, people were talking, associating with each other, just conferencing, having conversation, people that they haven't seen in a long time. I was just waiting for my sister to introduce me to this lady, whoever she is. And as I was going to stop my mom to come back, because I was waiting for my sister, I noticed that my mom was bowing down to this thing, and I got so like scared, starting to pray to God, like, please forgive my mom, please forgive my mom. So it's, we need to pray for our family. We, again, I said it in my last video, we need to pray for our family. We need to pray for our family. We need to pray for our family members. We need to keep them in our prayer. We need to ask God to give them understanding. We need to ask God to build a relationship with them. My mom is a Christian. She is an evangelist. She's like a pastor. She's someone that you can go to for advice. She's someone that you can speak to in a spiritual way. She is in tune with God, but she's older, and you know, like sometimes we don't know anything, and this is just a warning. This is just a message. And I got up, and I just feel like so like I need to get my life in order. I need to like I don't know. And we're all Christians. We're all Christians heading home. We're just coming from service. We're coming from church. So the church needs a wake up. This is like a wake-up call for the church, because we're not ready. We're not ready. We're not ready. And he is going to destroy this world, and some of us is going to get caught up in it. We are going to get caught up in this destruction, and we need to seek refuge in God. We need to trust him, and we need to like have him protecting us, hiding us underneath his wings. His wings, where we are protected, and nothing evil can come and harm us. Nothing that comes against us will be able to harm us. So we need to get our life together and put on the old armor of God. And right now, I honestly need to brace myself. I need to read about the armor of God, and you know, gird myself into the armor of him, so that I am protected if anything, and if any evil or anything that should come up to pass. So that is my message for today. I hope you guys have a great day, a great week, and a great month. And I'm telling you guys, you need to get right with God. So see you in my next video.